The Golden Globes happened a few weeks ago for anyone who cares. I doubt there is anyone listening out there who really does. Why should you? And I don't care either. Meaning I'm not invested in them the way I was when I was younger, say with the Oscars, which anyone still interested in movies and film culture can't help but pay attention to. Not because the Oscars are so cool or so great or that they actually give out prizes to the most deserving films. They often don't. We all know this. But they are a reflection of what Hollywood, the business, is dreaming about itself. How it sees itself. Representation is so important to them. And with a huge, fatuous inclusivity and diversity push, what the most flattering pose might be in the moment, as if inclusion and diversity have anything to do with awarding a movie's merits. Yes, this is the culture the Oscars are pushing, and it is rather nauseating. There are also sometimes great film artists involved in the mix. Certainly Alfonso Cuarón is going to be around Oscar night, cradling perhaps one or more statuettes. And when I say Hollywood on Oscar night, I mean prestige Hollywood, niche Hollywood, not the global Hollywood marketplace and the franchise movies and the animated hits and the comedies that do okay, and usually a very good animated movie wins. And even though Black Panther might get a Best Picture nomination, does it really deserve one? It does, however, have a Producers Guild nomination, and this is often seen as a precursor to an Oscar nom for Best Picture. Or, who knows, it might not. No superhero movie has ever gotten a Best Picture nomination. But believe me, Disney is doing everything in its power to make sure this happens, even though there is no one out here in La La Land I've met who thinks Black Panther is that good as a movie. Yet, as a piece of representation, they are supporting it. Ah yes, our old friends' ideology versus aesthetics are back into play. The entertainment press in the studio is selling the notion that Black Panther is a grand piece of cinematic art that cannot be ignored. And this notion is being shoved down our throats, and we can only smile in disbelief, or perhaps understand that this is just the moment we're trapped in. A joke. A hoax. It's all fake news, folks. Between the billion-dollar grosses of the Marvel movies and the high art ambitions of a few global directors, there is mostly the American middle-brow prestige picture that takes center stage during awards season. Maybe it's a little edgy, pushes a few buttons, but it is almost always a reassuring movie no matter how dark it goes. Conventional, often star-driven, with actors and actresses uglying it up. The Academy likes to look for heart, especially if a character has been a victim. It's even better if they're black, or especially a black female. This can be a shoo-in for supporting actress. Black Panther or no Black Panther, what I'm talking about, of course, when it comes down to the Oscars and their award season movies, are those noble endeavors that are supposed to lift the human spirit or wow us with the mild grimness of their visions, and where we can watch actors and actresses whirling up a storm. Many people think that Best Actor and Best Actress should really be retitled Most Actor and Most Actress. And when you take a look at last year's winners, from Gary Oldman in a fat suit as Winston Churchill, to Frances McDormand as the furious mother of a murder victim, to Allison Janney's, whoa, over-the-top bitch mom in I, Tonya, to Sam Rockwell as the dumb racist sheriff, that notion of most acting doesn't seem so far off. When Sam Rockwell gives the subtlest performance out of that group of winners, well, we are definitely in the land of a kind of acting in a kind of movie that awards season prefers. And I would have voted for both McDormand and Rockwell myself if I had a ballot.